the honest NGO is asked to file a suit and it is filed. So you can understand how. And Radia says, don't worry, I will ensure that after the formation of the ministry, Raja becomes the telecom minister. And you know, Mr. Ratan Tata tells her, somehow prevent Dayanidhi Maran from becoming telecom minister. This is one of the most honest and respected industrialists of this country. Cannot take his telephone and tell the Prime Minister. He has to tell a power broker. So the meaning and the extent of corruption, the reach of corruption, the definition of corruption has become now peddling of power at various levels. And the considerations exchanged are not corruption, consultancy fees, and there are various names attributed to this. And so you cannot really charge, Mr. Lal will not be able to charge somebody with corruption. If I have paid consultancy fee, what will he do in law? I am directly taking, it paycheck. So now, this has completely exposed that she worked to get licenses for four people, and the licenses, and she was able to get advance information about what the policy is and give it to the people who are the beneficiary. This is all on record today. But the media is keeping quiet. And the media cannot proceed beyond a particular point because biggest advertisers are involved. Where the revenue is pinched, they can't do anything. They will go to something else, some child labor is there, some rape case is there. Then they will hide it. They are only interested in the news of the moment. There is no Ramnath Goenka today who will pursue corruption continuously for 5 years. Face arrest, jail, 300 cases, prosecution. There is no one like that. One man can change the situation, one media can change the situation. Today the position is, the entire political system seems to be compromised. With practically no political party as the exception. Otherwise on this one issue, this government, if it doesn't fall, it has no answer. And this whole thing is pending before the Supreme Court. There are three issues pending. One is the cutoff date right? If the cutoff date is wrong, the entire licensing is quashed. Second, CBI investigation is going on. They have registered the case in 2009 October. Now the issue is proceeding. And Subramanian Swami had filed an application to prosecute Raja 18 months back. And see what happens to his application. He filed an application with the Prime Minister, and the Prime Minister forwarded the application to the Secretary Department of Telecom, and the Secretary for Department of Telecom forwarded the letter to Raja himself, and Raja wrote a personal letter to Subramanian Swami. I have heard honestly, why are you pursuing me? So you can understand how an issue of corruption in which the, and that is one of the things questioned in the Supreme Court. So we are laughing. But if you think a little, we are laughing only to reduce our pain. Today, if 1 lakh crores is available to the government of India, they will be able to tackle the petroleum prices issue better. They will be able to, we see the 3G licenses. 3G is a very, very difficult license to handle. It is not going to give the kind of money which a 2G license is going to give. Still, it has given you nearly 100,000 crores, they say. On that basis, the 2G licenses must give 200,000 crores. It is not revenue, it is sale of property, rare property, irreplaceable property, which the government has criminally underpriced. And at least 10 to 15 to 20,000 crores must have been shared between different people, including the people whom the Prime Minister cannot defy. Thank you very much.
I think a brilliant exposition, Garwati ji, we are very grateful to you. Well, in people have read in the newspaper in bits and pieces, the good number of travel disinformation, grey propaganda, trying to cover over the most of the facts. Today, everything that is said